Hi everyone, so I am going for a long walk, like 7 point something miles. You're probably like, she's crazy. But yes, that's what I'm doing. I normally am listening to music, that's why in my ears you can see I have headphones, but I thought I would turn it off so that I can talk to you guys. I feel like this video is gonna be a complete, like, truthful, not rant, but like, honest and open video, because I'm just gonna talk and reflect on everything. I'm actually walking towards Sunset Boulevard, and the thing is like, the reason why I like going this way is because right when you get to Sunset Boulevard here, all the houses change. And I love looking at like houses and all that, like really nice houses. So we're about to get to Sunset Boulevard right here. This isn't the Sunset Boulevard you're used to. It's not the one that, it's the same one, but it's the side that they don't usually show on TV. So you're probably gonna see it. Like, I'll show you it right now. And it's not all like flashy. It's just a regular road pretty much. So there you go. Yeah. So anyway, as I was saying, I love going on these walks because it's just a great time to reflect and think and plan for what, you know, where I'm going, where I'm heading, not where I'm physically going, but where I'm like career-wise going. I usually always go sometime in the evening because, not evening, but like four and after, because I don't like when it's too hot. So by this point, the sun is kind of going down and I can, you know, so I don't like die of heat exhaustion or something. I mean, you have to put, if you're going for this long of a walk, you have to like plan to do it at the ideal times. One thing that I do want to talk about though is like, I feel like there's this kind of notion that like LA is all glitz and glamour, but it really isn't. A lot of people make it seem that way. I'm sure some of you guys have that impression, even just from some of my videos, but it's not all glitz and glamour. And I say that for several reasons, because one, because a lot of times when you're doing that whole thing of going to like parties and events, you experience really, really snobby people. Sorry, I keep getting distracted because I keep seeing people stare at me all of a sudden. Okay, I'm switched hands with the camera. So anyway, a lot of people think that LA is all glitz and glam, but it's not. Like, we've had several bad encounters going to some of these parties where people are snobby or snooty, or the door person is rude. And like, for example, well, I don't know if I should, I'm not bad mouthing the person, but so we went to this party the other night, and like, it was hosted by this, I guess, celeb. I don't really think he's a celeb. He probably thinks he's a celeb, but he is like on like the D list, I guess you can say. And so he was the host of the party, and it was for a launch of a product he was launching. And they had this like photo booth thing, and it turned out that like he was apparently walking through the photo booth with his friend at the same time me and my friend were going to the photo booth. And so then we get there at the same time, and since he's the host of the party, we're like, oh, you know, hey, jump in the photo booth with us or whatever for like some quick, you know, snaps, just be like, you know, in the photo booth. And he was like, no, you guys do yours and then we'll do ours. And we're just like, okay, Mr. Host of the party, you know. And I was kind of just like, it's different. It's different if it was just a random. It's like, for example, if you see celebrities on the street and you walk up to them and you're like, oh, can I get a picture or something? I can see why they would say no. But if it's a situation where you're hosting the party for your launch and we were invited, you're not even gonna like have fun with some of your guests and be a good, you know, say hi or whatever. Like, it's kind of just like, okay, so why are we here? But anyway, so then another thing too. Oh, so let me tell you guys about this. So I went to for brunch today with a friend, and it was nice. It was really good. I had fun with her. We hadn't talked in a while, so it was nice to have brunch. And it was all good until we got the bill at the end. And not because of the meal. I have no problems paying for the meal. But the orange juice, we each got a glass of orange juice. And the orange juice was $9 each. I'm laughing because I'm thinking of my friend who always makes fun of the way I say dollars. Because I'm Canadian, she's always like, dollars, dollars. And I was like, is that how we say it? But anyway, I think she wants me to say dollars or something like that. But anyway, I don't know if that's the American way, dollars. But anyway, so it was $9. And I was just like, I don't want to pay for a glass of orange juice, $9? Like, unless those oranges are coming from, you know, are exclusively imported from the tropical rainforest of somewhere, I don't see why we should be paying $9 for a small glass of orange juice. Look at this house right there. Isn't that so nice? Just sitting here fawning, or standing here fawning over people's. Oh my gosh. Bratty children. Oh my gosh, look at that house there. It's like a medieval times or something. I don't know if you can see it well. Let's see. Maybe I just zoom in. Hang on a second. Yeah, look at that house. It's like the doors are made from iron something. Isn't that cool? So that's what I like about the houses here. That like they all have different character. They're not like, you know, cookie cutter houses like back home. Like even look at this one. You know, all the houses have character. Seriously. They all look different, and you can put your own touch on your house. So, what was I saying? Oh gosh, you guys are probably like, why did you wear makeup for exercising? Because I came from a brunch first before I started exercising. But anyway, so yeah, on the topic of snooty, snotty people. So like even at that one, that product launch we went to, the guy, the funny thing, he was so snobby, and it was like, it's not even like oh my gosh, look at this house. You guys, this video is going to be me fawning over every house. But that's why I like coming on these walks. I love to like just, you know, admire the houses and stuff like that. Isn't that so big? One day. Oh, and one thing I want to address too is like, one time somebody asked me, they said, oh, Essie, why are you so obsessed with making lots of money? And I said to them, I'm not obsessed with making a lot of money. I'm obsessed with freedom. And making a lot of money is what's gonna get me to freedom. I don't wanna live a life where I'm worrying about bills and debt all the time and, you know, living paycheck to paycheck and all that stuff. I don't wanna do that. I hate that. And I feel like that's what traps people in living a lifestyle they don't wanna live, is because all these bills and this debt, the debt from school and student loans and all this stuff, credit card bills and all that stuff. And that's what traps people. That's what makes people live these lives, live their whole lives doing something they don't even love because of that. And so for me, making lots of money is the key to me not having to worry about that. I don't want to worry about bills and debt. I want to be able to just live my life and, you know, and not have to be pinching pennies or living paycheck to paycheck. So that's why I want to make a lot of money. I'm obsessed with freedom, and making a lot of money is what's going to give me that freedom to do whatever I want on my terms. So that's what it is. It's not that I'm obsessed with making money, it's that I'm obsessed with freedom and what freedom gives me, which is happiness ultimately. And also too, not just freedom in terms of from debt, it's like freedom of being able to do what you want with your time. Like the fact that, you know, people go to work every day and then have these short vacations in this limited window of the time that their employer controls. Because you have to book your time off, and your employer can be like, no, you can't take that time off because we need it that week. It's like being controlled by somebody else. So it's kind of like, even time-wise, I want to be able to, if I want to travel, I want to be able to travel. I don't want to be, you know, at the mercy at my boss to give me time off. So that's another reason that, that's another thing that pushes me to like work so hard and chase after these dreams that I talk about so often. So anyway, back to the topic of the guy who was like so snooty. It was kind of like weird because it wasn't even someone who's worked hard to like get to where they are, and so that's why they've gotten kind of like cocky or arrogant or whatever. Sometimes I see how people get like that when they've achieved something great. This guy was born into wealth. His father is wealthy, and that's why he's therefore wealthy. He's never had to work hard for anything. Yeah, he was so snooty, as if he was like the greatest, you know, something that ever came. So anyway, you encounter a lot of weird folks like that. See, the area we're getting to right now is when the houses get massive. Like, even that. Look at that gate. It goes all the way up to some hidden oasis or something. Even look at that house. That house there looks like Road to Avonlea or something. Or Anne of Green Gables. Oh, another thing I want to talk about, too, is, like, my YouTube channel and all that stuff. Like, I've had people ask me, oh, Essie, why can't you make more videos more often? And, like, it's hard. It's, like, making YouTube videos are not easy. It takes a lot of time to edit and all that stuff. And at this time, I don't have the time to make videos more often. I wish I could. I wish I could release videos, like, at least twice a week. But right now, I'm even struggling just with keeping up at the once a week every Thursday. I can't even keep up with that at the moment. So for me to add another video every single week, so that'd be two videos per week, there's no way I can do that. But the good thing is, though, is I just got a Snapchat. So that way, if you guys wanna stay updated faster, you can add me on Snapchat, where I'm always updating like several times a week, sometimes multiple times a day. Like, literally, you see everything I'm doing in like real time too. That's the thing with my videos. I post, the videos often come out way after the events have already occurred. Whereas like the great thing about Snapchat, which I'm learning now because I'm just learning how to use it, is that you know, you can just do it in real time. Like, you can see what the person's actually doing and all the things they're experiencing fast, right? Like, literally at the time it happens. So anyway, my new Snapchat is, of course, Essie Magic, because everything on social media for me is Essie Magic. Oh, too, and also another way to keep up with me, if you think the YouTube videos are too few and far in between, is my Instagram. My Instagram, I upgrade it several times a week, and you'll see everything happening fast there, too. And that's also Essie Magic as well. Oh gosh, this is where we run out of sidewalk, so you have to be very careful because get run over by a car. So I'm gonna cross, I'm gonna walk on the road, and I'm gonna face traffic so that they can see me and don't run me over. So for those of you who don't know, my goal right now is to get all the way till this road ends. That literally is getting to the mountains, the very end. For really how it works is like, kind of like the closer you get to the mountains, the bigger and more exquisite the houses get. Oh, and that reminds me, I still have not yet filmed my Q&A video. I've had people message me and be like, Essie, when are you gonna do the Q&A video? I still haven't filmed it. So if you have any questions, literally about anything, it can be about life in LA, it can be about me personally, my favorite things, what you're curious to know about me, what I like and don't like, anything, literally, you can ask me. And I should be filming that video this week, or actually after this video comes out, it'll be the following week. So there's still time to ask me questions. You can just tweet them to me at Ask Essie, hashtag Ask Essie, or you can put it in this video, I guess, like in the comment section. I really should emphasize as well that if there's something you really want to know and you've perhaps messaged me in some other way and I haven't responded, it's best you ask me for this Ask Essie video. Because the reason is, like, for example, yesterday or 2 days ago, I was just experimenting with Instagram, and then I see all of a sudden I have 20 direct message requests. And I was just like, what the? Because I don't even pay attention to, like, there's too much social media. I don't even pay attention to every single one fast enough. So I get there and I see like 20 message requests, and I'm just like, oh gosh, all these people who've been messaging me, asking me questions. And and I haven't responded because I didn't know it was there. So at least if you ask it for me in the video, at least for the video, at least it will get answered for sure. Even with Facebook, on my Facebook page, I won't see a message till like 2 months after the person messaged me. So anyway, this, like I said, this is the best time to ask me all these questions. I'm sure some people are like, whoa, why would you walk 7 miles? I'm not even someone who's in wicked shape. It's not like I'm one of those ripped people who does, you know, the more you go, the more you add to your exercise routine. I'm just being crazy because I'm trying to get in shape, and when I'm trying to do stuff, I'm always extreme about it. Like, I'm the type of person, when I'm dedicated to something, I will do everything to do it, like, to get it done. Like, you know, if I have to, like, if I'm working on something and I'm willing to get it done, I'll block everything out to just get it done. Same with exercising. If I really want to get in shape, I'm gonna push myself so hard to do it. I don't know if that's good or bad. I mean, it could be good sometimes, it could be bad, because then it's like extreme and you can exhaust yourself and all that, but I don't know. Time will tell. So also, just to let you know, the further you go up this road, the closer you get to the hills and the mountains. So if you look there, you can see we're heading towards the mountains and we're getting closer and closer. And also, which means that the incline changes. So that's why I'm breathing so hard, because it's getting, you know, higher and higher. Oh my gosh, look at this house here. It's like, it's so nice. So anyway, the higher you get, see, this is where I start getting all obsessed with the houses and I'm not even concentrating on what I'm saying. Honestly, one of my favorite TV shows is House Hunters on HGTV. So that's why I like, it's obvious why I see these houses here and I'm like, oh my gosh, because, you know, I like that kind of stuff. And it's nice to fantasize about one day getting to that myself. Honestly, I think fantasizing is very healthy. Fantasizing is what breeds, you know, motivation, and what breeds that sort of like setting those goals and deciding you're going to do something is through fantasizing and envisioning stuff. Oh, look at this here. So this is like a gated community, I think. Can't be one person's house. The path so far. Let me see if I can like zoom in. Oh no, I won't zoom in because it's like, I don't want to look stalkerish. Ooh, this house, the gate is open. Should I just go on in? Guys, look at this house. Like, even that, like, it's so modern and futuristic looking. Like, I just love the fact that you can make your house look however you want, you know? It's amazing. You can put your personal touch on things. Even this house looks, you go from a modern house to a like a old cabin looking house. So as you can see, this is what I do when I'm not working hard and I'm not going to events or hanging out with people. I just do stuff like this where I just wander off and explore, see what's out there for me. Never be afraid. I always tell people, never be afraid to explore, because that's when you discover what the world really has to offer, honestly. I mean, obviously within reason, don't go like where there's wildlife or anything, but you know, within reason. We're getting closer and closer though, because look, like I said, as you get closer to the mountains, so you can see the mountains there, the houses on the hills, that's when you know you're getting to the end of this street. Also too, I don't want you guys to get the wrong impression of me, but I'm not the type of person, I just want to reiterate that I'm not the type of person who's obsessed with like designer stuff. That's why you don't really see a lot of videos of me like shopping and stuff like that. Like, even when I get my dream house, I should say, I'm still gonna drive like a Toyota or like a Prius, a Toyota Prius or something simple. Like I said, I just want to be free, and a nice house is also okay. I don't know what a nice house is like. Obviously you don't have to live in a big house once you have the money, but that's the one thing I do want, as you can see by everything I'm saying. But in terms of everything else, like a Range Rover Escalade, all these cars, and you know, Lexus and BMW, all this stuff, I don't care about that. Almost there, guys. This is further than I came the last time, so success is coming. In case you're wondering what I'm wearing, stereotypical workout leggings. There it is, you guys. There's a sign there that literally even says end. I made it to the end. Woohoo! Success! I made it to the end of the road. As you guys can see, let me turn this around. Oh, yay! Woohoo! As you guys can see, I'm right in the mountains, like literally in the mountains right now. Now that I think about this, probably isn't that safe for me to come here alone. I wouldn't advise doing this at night, actually. Because literally somebody could just like kidnap me, rape me, and then throw my body in there. It's not funny, but I always make jokes of everything. So downhill walking is 10 times easier than uphill, so this part's gonna be a breeze. Anyway, so I hope you enjoyed this video, and as always, make sure you subscribe so that you don't miss out on new videos. I release new videos every Thursday, or I try to release new videos every Thursday, and give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed my rant. Well, I don't know if it was a rant, my reflection slash rant thing. Yeah, and if you like these type of videos, let me know. I mean, I can really talk if I want to. So let me know, and I'll make more of stuff like that where I'm just like talking to you and all that. Yeah, so as always, as you can see, oh my gosh, look at that, the mountains there and the house on top. I don't know if you can see. Oh my gosh, look at that. My goodness, it's like a little house on the top there. Oh gosh, again, why I love LA. I need to stop saying that, but it's just, honestly, it really is magic. When you look at some of it, like the things people do here, it's just crazy. In a good way though. So anyway, before I got distracted there, I was just about to say, keep being magic, bye. Sorry, I know I said I would be gone, or I was saying bye, but I just wanted to show you some of the nice houses that I'm seeing on the way back in the hills there. But anyway, yeah, I'll stop this now. Okay, bye for real now, bye. Again, sorry, I said I was done filming, but I just wanted to illustrate one more point about how it's not all sunshine and daisies here. It is cold, so now I put my hood on my hoodie, and heading back home. It's cold. It's not hot here all the time like people think. It's actually kind of cold at certain places and at certain times of the evening. So anyway, I just wanted to say that. So yeah, anyway, bye, keep being magic, thanks for watching.